Hey guys, it's Mike from the Geek Pub, and on this episode, we're going to make this awesome USB charger circuit that can power all of your devices. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to make a USB charger circuit that can be used to power smartphones, tablets, or just about anything else that accepts USB. But before we get started, I should mention a few things that you should be aware of. First, we're working with 120 volts mains power. If you're not comfortable with working with high voltage and don't understand the risks, you should probably seek some help with this project. Second, we're going to build this circuit on a breadboard. Most breadboards are only capable of carrying a maximum of 1 amp. Some brands carry far less. Our USB charger circuit is capable of 2 amps. Since we're just making a prototype for demonstration purposes, I won't plug anything in that would pull that much current as a safety. Well, oops. If you want to use this circuit with higher power devices, you'll want to solder these components to a permanent circuit board like this one. And lastly, the transformer I'm using is almost the size of my fist, because that's what I had laying in my parts bin. You can get a much smaller one. The same goes for just about every component I'm using in this project, so don't let the size scare you. If you need something smaller for your project, you can get it. The first thing we need to do in our USB charger circuit is to step down the voltage from 120 volts AC to something our charger circuit can handle, and something that is safer for us to work with. To do that, I'm going to use this 120 volt to 12 volt step down transformer that was laying in my parts bin. Again, it's a little big, but it's all I had on hand. I'll just connect it to this mains power cord using a couple of wire nuts. So I'll just plug my multimeter's leads into the output side, plug in the transformer, and you can see we're getting about 14 volts, exactly what we'd expect with no load on the transformer. Now we have the 12 volts we need to work with, but it's currently 12 volts AC, and we need to convert that output to DC. To do that, we're going to create a bridge rectifier out of 4 diodes. You can buy pre-made rectifiers, but everyone should make their own at least once to learn how they work. So if we hook our rectifier circuit up to the multimeter and measure DC voltage, we get about 13.5 volts DC. Looks good, right? Well, if we look at it on the oscilloscope, things are a little off. That doesn't look like DC at all. So what's going on here? Since diodes only allow current to flow in a single direction, what we've done is eliminated the negative side of the AC wave and left ourselves with a DC oscillation. We'll solve this by adding filter capacitors to the circuit. These filter caps will go on both sides of a voltage regulator. They will charge until the oscillation reaches its peak, and then as the oscillation falls low, the capacitors will discharge into the circuit, flattening out the oscillations and creating DC. The voltage regulator has the effect of lowering our 12 volt input voltage down to 5 volts. And then we'll keep our voltage at a stable 5 volts, even if the input voltage changes up or down. Now you can see on the oscilloscope, we have a perfectly stable 5 volt DC reading. I took this old USB cord and cut the end off of it. I just attached some JST connectors to make it easy to plug into my breadboard. So now it's time to try it out. Here it is powering my LTE hotspot. And here it is powering my Pi 1541. I have a video on building one of these. Here it is powering my favorite Raspberry Pi battery pack, the Pi Juice. And finally, here it is powering my Amazon Alexa. So it is important to note that this is not the most efficient charging circuit that you can build for USB devices. As a matter of fact, there's basically a system on a chip that is a single chip with a few inputs and outputs that will do all of this for you with just a few wires and much more efficiently. The problem is that doesn't really make a very good teaching tutorial. As a matter of fact, it's basically magic. And so with this, we can discover each individual step of converting AC high voltage down to a regulated 5 volt DC that your USB devices can use. So that's the reason that I chose this method. That's all for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.